Yes, dear children. Let us continue with the class. So, in the last class, we have done up till page 264. That's the preamble, right? So, let us start today from 265. The next topic, that's sovereignty. Let's see what this sovereignty means. After years of being a British colony, it was important for India to proclaim its independent status. The preamble states that India is a sovereign country, which means that the government of the country has an absolute independent authority over the areas within the territorial boundaries. Please underline that. The preamble states that India is a sovereign country. This means that the government of the country has an absolute independent authority over the areas within the territorial boundaries of the country. Up till there. The country is free from any external control. Alright, in simple language, now let me explain. Sovereignty, sovereign. In simple term, that means no outside interference. Simple as that. The territory, the area which is under your control, which belongs to you, it's completely in your hand. Any decision of any matter with regard to, you know, which is within the territory, you have the complete authority to decide, to make law, or, you know, to take any decision of that particular area, of that particular territory which lies within your boundary. No neighborhood, no outsider, no matter whoever he or she is, maybe a superpower or whoever, maybe my friend, whosoever, has no right to interfere. That's called sovereign. Okay, I'm just explaining in simple terminology, simple language. Always try to understand things, you know, understand in a basic way. What happens is that when you understand things in a basic concept, with a basic manner, it fits in into this system forever. But when you try to understand things, you know, into this, what you call big terminologies and all bookish knowledge, without understanding the concept, I'm not saying that bookish knowledge is not important, but what I'm trying to tell you is that the concept is most important. If you have the concept, you can frame it by your own, in your own language. It's who I am, you know, I'm not saying that you have to just cut paste from the textbook the way it is. Frame it in your own language. It's well and good. Okay, show your creativity. I just want the answer. I don't want this, what you call, robots copying. No. By telling you this basic concept, I remember, all of a sudden, I remember there is a movie, yeah, a Bollywood movie, which tells about this, what you call, student's life, college, Three Idiots, yes. Out there is a particular part in that movie. Once the teacher was asking, I believe you guys have seen, what is a machine, right? I still remember that concept because it's related to students and teachers, education. Then the main character of the movie, he says that anything which makes human works easier is called a machine. A switch is a machine, right? A fan is a machine, or you can say a remote is a machine. We press the key and then the TV channel changes and all. So anything. But whereas the same question when it was asked to another student, the student gave a long definition, cut paste. All the words from the book. So I hope you got me, what I'm trying to tell you, that what is more important is your understanding. You must understand things. When you understand things, you will even develop that interest towards studies. And you know, once you are interested towards studies, nothing can stop you from climbing up the ladder of success. Next, federalism. We have already studied that in a vast country like India, the government functions at two levels, that is central and state. There are also local governments in villages and cities. The constitution defines the federal structure, which means government at two levels. The constitution also clearly defines the power and functions of two levels of the government. Alright, again, let me explain in simple term. A federal structure or federal government simply means that the central government, or you can say the, you know, the union, is sharing its power with the various constituent units. It can be state, it can be even local. Even local government has got certain power, right? Otherwise, this municipal corporation, town committee, or you can talk about in this rural area, what is that? Panchayat. They also have got certain power. That is how they manage things. They look after the village, the locality, and you know, they do their duties and all. As because they have power, they are being authorized. So this power, from where did they get? Or you talk about the state government, you talk about the local government, and if there is any other form of government coming up in the near future, don't know. But as of now, okay, local government, state government, and all. So basically, the power being, and it is defined in the constitution, you know, as per the constitution, that the government must, you know, share, the union government, the central government must share its power with its various constituent unit. Or you can say that government at different levels, center, state, and local government, even that can be said. Okay, that is called federalism, federal structure. Next, we have a parliamentary form of government. What is parliamentary form of government? The parliament is the central legislature. Through general elections, we elect representatives to the parliament. The constitution mentions that India has a parliamentary form of government, and it clearly mentions the powers and functions of the parliament as well. Alright. Now, parliamentary form of government means the representatives whom we elect. Alright. This elected representatives, okay, they go to the parliament, this through general elections. All right now, as per the constitution, I repeat once again, parliamentary form of government, the elected representatives, they go to the parliament, and parliament is the main central legislature for the country. Okay, like we have a state legislature, this MLS, member of the legislative assembly, state, every state has got the state legislature. Parliament is a central legislature, simple as that. Okay. Now, in the constitution, it is clearly mentioned that India has got a parliamentary form of government, and also the constitution talks about the powers that the parliament has, and also its function, duties, the work that the parliament must perform. Universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise means every adult of that particular country. Now, for example, say India follows universal adult franchise, okay, so which means every adult citizen of our country, irrespective of caste, creed, gender, religion, okay, has got the right to vote. That's called universal adult franchise. Universal, sabko, everybody, adult 18 years and above, franchise, right to vote. Next, we have a separation of powers. The constitution clearly demarcates and defines the powers and roles of the three organs of the government. Underline the three organs of the government, that's the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. Now, what is the work of the legislature? The legislature frame laws. What about executive? They implement them. And the judiciary, they resolve disputes and maintain law. And I'll explain you in a simple terminology what do you mean by legislature. Even I hope most of you know, or even if you don't, it's okay. Legislature, you can say the ministers, the MLA MPs, okay, legislature, they frame law. You know how laws are being made in parliament, it has to be passed, majority of the MPs, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, these, that, then it will go to the president, will have to. So ultimately what happens is that it is the legislature who frame law. Executive, who implements the law. I think recently you might have seen this, what do you call, the SOPs which are being, you know, directed from the government ends with regard to this COVID, coronavirus. You see, have you seen the orders, the SOPs below the person who has signed by order? You will see it will be written that, Chief Secretary, IS, something like that. So basically executives are high officials, you can say the bureaucrats, the civil servants. All right. Next comes judiciary. Judiciary is the judge, the legal, the high court, supreme court judge and all, who resolves the disputes, if there's any dispute, any conflict, they come into the picture, they solve it out, okay? And they may also maintain the law and order, because what the order that is being passed from their end, that needs to be followed. Next, we have secularism. Shall we keep it up to this much today? Separation of, yeah, there is a fact box. Let me read that fact box and then we will end the class here for the day. And by next class, we will end up this chapter, right? No need to hurry, no need to rush. First of all, you have to understand. Let's see what fact, something for our knowledge. Our constitution has been inspired by several constitutions across the world. It has adopted from the British constitution, the parliamentary form of government, rule of law, institution of the speaker. From the US constitution, fundamental rights, federal structure of the government and independence of the judiciary. From the Irish constitution, the directive principles. From the French constitution, the ideals of liberty, equality and fraternity. Even though it is a fact box, quite important, it will be included for your examination. Now, see, I want you to grab the knowledge just for the sake, for the fear of examination, that it will come in the examination, so let me study just for the sake of marks. No, if you have that, trust me, my dear children, the moment examinations are over, you'll forget everything, because you just studied for the sake of examination, which I don't want. I want you all, you know, to remember this for your knowledge, so that you don't forget in your ever, you know, until and unless, as long as you survive, so that it helps you to grow, to develop your own talent, your own information, okay? But at the same time, you all are children. You also get distracted by games, sports and all. So can't help it. I'll include this for your examination, okay? So please mug it up. Memorize that our Indian constitution, they got inspired from the other constitutions of the world and from each and every constitution, from some of the constitution, like from British, from US, from Irish, from French. They took some of the ideas, some of the policies, and as a result, they drafted this Indian constitution. So from which constitution, okay, what was being adopted, like from the British constitution, parliamentary form, from the US, fundamental rights, from the Irish, directive principles, from the French, idea of liberty, equality, fraternity. So all these things were adopted from different, and as a result, drafted Indian constitution. So you need to know this. I'll mark it down so that later on I do not forget. That's a very important thing, huh? Okay, fine. The remaining topic, we will do it in the next class. We'll end up out here. Please go through whatever has been explained and read the text thoroughly. That's enough for you. No, you don't have to go for any other notes. Read the text, listen to the explanation, do the assignments. That's all enough. It's enough for you, more than enough, nothing else. All right, see you in the next class then. Study well.